Quai des Polars.
Quai du Polar.
Quai du Polar.
Quai du Polar.
Quai du Polar.
So in L'ombre de la baleine, we meet three characters. First, there's Samuel. He's a young boy. He's 18. He's a nice guy, but he's in a lot of trouble because he's using drugs and he's selling drugs. After he has a really big problem and a fight with one of the gangsters, basically, in town, he has to flee. So he escapes to a small island in the archipelago. Obviously, his problems, they don't end there, they escalate. The only person he can think of to help him is his mother, and that's the second person. Her name is Pernilla. Now, Pernilla she's a young mother. She's only, I think she's 37. She had Samuel when she was very young. And she's very religious, and she has all these rules, these very strict rules that she lives by. And when Samuel asks her for help, it's a test for her because she will have to break all these rules, basically. So we'll see how far she's prepared to go to help her son. And then there's Manfred, and he's a police officer. And in the very beginning of the book, and I think I can say this without spoiling the story, his young daughter has an accident and is very ill, so she ends up in a coma in a hospital, and it takes a long while before we know if she actually manages to survive. I really like the first person perspective because I think it gives a sort of intimacy, a feeling that you are actually there with the person, somebody's telling the story to you. I've written actually quite a few books in first person. I really like that. But it's mainly because of that, because it creates intimacy. Most of us, we have problems. We have issues. We are afraid of things, or we have bad habits. We all have flaws. We all have problems. And for me, I really want to create credible characters, people that you feel, characters that you feel are real people, real persons. And if something is perfect, if they're perfect, it's not interesting. So they need to have problems, they need to have flaws in order for them to be credible and for the reader to be engaged. Because it's only when you're engaged that you can create suspense. It's not via, you know, killings or blood or cars chasing each other. It's you need that emotional commitment from the reader. You want them to connect to the characters. I would say I'm more of a thriller writer than a traditional police writer. My aim is to have a good psychological depth in the novel, so to speak.